Welcome to the pulmonary function testing laboratory housed in the inhalation exposure core. What I want to show you are several methods for measuring lung function in non-human primates that have direct translation to human disease. The first that I'm going to talk about is the measurement of airway hyperresponsiveness. And to do that, what we need to do is have a measure of airway resistance and elastance. The system we use to do that is right here. We measure what is called transfer impedance. What we do is we place the animal in a plethysmograph, the animal is anesthetized and intubated, and we measure flow at the mouth and pressure generated on the thorax by these two spheres. We then take that data and derive airway resistance and the elastance of the respiratory system. Those change when we provide a challenge using this ventilator to deliver either histamine as a challenge, methacholine, or in the case of allergic asthma, sometimes allergen. We measure the changes in airway resistance with each of those challenges, plot again on a dose response curve to get a measure of airway hyperresponsiveness. Airway hyperresponsiveness is a critical measure in asthma, but it's also been shown more recently that airway hyperresponsiveness in non-asthmatic individuals is a risk factor for accelerated lung aging and also for increased risk for the development of COPD. So studying airway hyperresponsiveness by itself is an important endpoint for the study of the physiology and respiratory physiology of non-human primates and how that translates to the human condition. This is another system for measuring lung function in non-human primates. It's based upon the principle of chest compression, and it allows us to measure forced expiratory flows in anesthetized intubated animals. What this system allows us to do is get direct translational information from a non-human primate that can be directly compared with data in the human literature. This is another system for measuring lung function in non-human primates. Animals are anesthetized and placed in this plethysmograph, and we measure flows at the mouth and pressure changes in the plethysmograph that allow us to measure lung volumes. And those lung volumes are directly translational to measures that would be done in human subjects and patients using spirometry.